Guardate questa barca. Non fatevi ingannare dalle tappezzerie color.
Look at this boat. Don't be fooled by the beige upholstery. Under the common pleasure boat appearance lays the best technology in the industry.
Questo modello è lo Stab 38, costruito.
This model is the Stab 38, built by FB Design. Its hull was built based on the Sunracer 38, a competition hull, also of FB Design, which won endurance races and championships in the early 2000s.
Lo scafo è inaffondabile perché
the hull is unsinkable because it's been constructed with a method called structural foam, a special patent of the FB design that involves the injection of polyurethane foam throughout the lower portion of the hull in separate compartments.
Già. Ma per spingere una barca così.
Okay, but to propel a boat like this, special engines might be needed. Let's see what they put under the hood.
Due motori Mercury diesel.
Two Mercury diesel 6.7-liter 550 horsepower engines, six cylinders in line, 6,700 cubic centimeters, 24 valves, common rail feeding, supercharged and aftercooled.
Guardate come li hanno sistemati, ci stanno.
Look at how they're fitted. They're down to the millimeter. But the boat is just 2.33 meters wide overall, so they're very compact. I think it's obvious that all this technology needs to be tested.
Strumentazione Mercury Vessel View. Sistema automatico.
Mercury Vessel View Instruments, FB Automatic Flap Design Regulation, separate controls, accelerator and inverter. These engines have a nice sound. What do you think? Let's go planing. Like all racing hulls, you have to help it a little bit into planing. The flaps are lowered all the way, automatically by the system, and the pilot, if he wants, can facilitate the operation with a few turns. So it leans better on the exterior of the hull. To plane more easily, once you stretch out on the water, you have to decrease the gas immediately, otherwise you'll take off.
Facciamo finta di essere su una tranquilla imbarcazione da diporto e di navigare a questa velocità.
Let's pretend to be on a quiet pleasure boat and navigate at this speed, 27 knots. At this time the engines are consuming a total of about 54 liters. That is, we are traveling half a mile with a liter of diesel. The flaps are still low. There is still a bit of hydrodynamic resistance, so let's give some more gas.
Diamo gas.
At 30 knots, it extends wonderfully over the water. The windshield works, it's a vertical deflector that raises the air completely. And here, at the command post, it feels like I'm in an armchair.
A proposito, questi sedili...
By the way, these seats are adjustable depending on body weight and are also equipped with shock absorbers. In short, sailing really is a pleasure.
Lo Stab 38 si chiama così perché ha due salsi...
Stab 38 is so called because it has lateral tubes. Yes, two semi-tubulars that help to stabilize it in extreme situations, such as sharp turns or over the waves. At 1,900 revolutions per minute, these engines already reach their maximum torque, 1.580 newton meter.
E a questo regime la velocità è di 37 nodi.
And at this regime, the speed is 37 knots. The consumption is 75 liters per hour total. In short, we are more or less on the order of half a mile with a liter.
Questa barca è stata progettata e costruita da Fabio Buzzi, l'unico uomo al mondo.
This boat was designed and built by Fabio Buzzi, the only man in the world capable of making boats and propulsion, and then drive them to the limit, to gain success in competitions and beat speed records. And it is speed that we are talking about today, with these engines. The engine block is built by FPT Industrial, who, with this engine, have run in motor racing competitions, winning races and championships. It has a ladder frame. It's very robust to withstand the toughest stresses. The rods are fracture split, a technology that allows them to withstand the high pressures under which the pistons are subjected. We are at 45 knots, 2,200 RPM, 90 liters per hour, still half a mile per liter, despite these 1,100 horses. Consumption is not high. The weight-to-power ratio of this unit is 1.31 kilograms per horsepower. Remarkable, isn't it? And a horsepower-to-capacity ratio of 82 horsepower per liter. This is quite a high result in the marine industry.
In questa configurazione stiamo utilizzando delle propulsioni di superficie ZF Marine.
In this configuration we are using ZF Marine surface drives, but of course the Mercury 6.7L, 550 horsepower, even in low power versions, can be matched to a traditional shaft line of Mercury Zeus pod drive.
È una barca da corsa perché ha anche il...
It is a racing boat because it has all the ballast controlled with these levers. Ballast tanks are tanks that can be filled and emptied to adjust the boat's trim. But today on the lake, so flat, there is no need for it. Today, with a surface like so, what we want to see is the maximum speed. I do not have to do anything, just control the helm with the tip of my finger, because the hull begins to be light on the water, but it keeps the trajectory. I focus on the point where I want to go. There is a bit of traffic and I have to be very careful because we are at 70 knots. 70 knots! 70 knots! The engines are at 3,100 RPM and consumption is 218 liters per hour. Traveling at 70 knots, that consumption is ridiculous.
Ma sono motori solo da corsa? No. Ho provato le stesse unità su una navetta.
But are they just racing engines? No, I tried the same models on a 17-meter shuttle, and at 7 knots, the consumption was 1 liter per mile, a record for a yacht of about 25 tons.
Il nuovo motore Mercury 6.7L diesel da 550.
The new 550 horsepower Mercury 6.7 liter diesel engine is compatible with the entire range of electronic controls and smart craft, including the piloting joystick. In short, whatever your boat, a quiet trawler or a motorboat, this engine can only make it better.